very quick rundown of the trials and tribulations of making this video. So, Dev and I played through the level as usual until Dev managed to not record the first half hour of footage, which is why the first 30 minutes of his perspective has been reenacted poorly. We were struggling on a puzzle, and I was confident how I just couldn't get into this 3-tile high passageway because of VVVVV's wall-hugging mechanics, so we decided to each edit our respective levels to progress. It turns out in Dav's level, the keypad was broken, which means he couldn't actually progress either. Really great playtesting here on Lollipop's part. Lastly, during the editing of this video, my editing software came alive. Somebody synced the audio of some videos I was using to make the final video, which was fun for me to debug. I initially thought it was codec at first, and even more fun for me to fix and work around. That was all fun to deal with. Now here's hoping the universe doesn't screw you over too when watching this very long in the making video. Issho ni by Lollipop HTTP :// oshu.whatever.that is. Can you work together to make it out for two players, player one version, quad VVV, player two version says platers.
Yeah, I noticed.
Okay, I'll be playing player one with Dav.
Okay, then I'll be playing player two then.
Alright. So let's see here.
Okay, I have a terminal.
Before you jump in, this map was meant to be played with two people. You'd have contact with another person who has the other version of this map. Okay, I do.
Yeah, hop down and get started. Did the room just change, or...?
What?
Not only did the gravity lines disappear, it seemed like it changed a bit, but... Yeah, I found something disappeared in the wall. So I'm in the third room now, I think.
I'm in a maze, apparently.
I went to the right and there's now a terminal. I can't see how much different your level is, so maybe we're gonna be lost forever now, because everything is different.
Oh, the room changed for me as well. Okay, we're in a maze, apparently. And of course there's no signal, so I can't...
I do have signal. I'm in the fourth room. And it has a terminal, a few spikes.
I have encountered the rooms.
So you have no signal on the map, and...
I have no signal.
You're lost.
Yeah. I have no idea. No. I mean, I can check for warping. It's trivial to check for warping. Only on horizontal, though. I can't tell if vertical warps or not.
The third room was warping, and I could go to the right. But anyway,
I went into another room. I could tell because there was no warps. Okay, and that's another room.
I'm not sure where you are right now.
I'm in a pink room with a...
I'm still in the fourth room to the right, and I have a terminal. Remember the room?
Oh, I'm in the red. I'm red. Oh, that terminal. Remember the room?
That was a snippet of the final maze.
I don't know what that... I have no idea where I'm going. Alright. I see what Lollipop did here. Oh, that's a warp. I mean, that's not a warp.
Maybe we should restart, because I think we're just not going to be on the same page anymore. Your friend is in a similar predicament. Like, how are we going to sing this back again? Except he probably hasn't made it out yet. Ah, that explains, I think.
Are you supposed to wait for me or something? Wait, have you made... Oh, I'm in the blue room now. Have you made it out?
Well, I could just go to the right. It warped on the left, but then I went to the right, and then it went to the next room. And it the terminal says you probably didn't make it out yet. In other news, these spikes look quite suspicious, although I don't
see... Oh, there we go, what's this?
Either of you.
I made it out first.
Oh, well, these spikes have different directions, and it seems like I have to point where you need to go. Except if you made it out already, then that's not necessary.
Okay. Alright, so I guess this is another section of the level. So I should probably not...
I'm just gonna walk on.
Wall of numbers, yeah, it says I have to work with my partner.
I have a couple of warps right now, 4, 5, and 6. And there's terminal. Note, the order matters. And... Oh shit, there's a wall glitch. And there's another terminal, and the order matters. I found 6 warps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And there's a wall glitch here. And there's another room where there are 2 terminals, and a lot of numbers.
Alright, yeah, looks like I have to wait for you to get out of the maze. I can't help you, for some reason.
Maybe I'll just take the first warp and then see where it goes. It's now another maze, kind of... there's another warp token at the bottom. And I'm... I probably... Oh. And dying just brings me back to the room with the rooms with the warps. 4, 2, 3. I'm just gonna note that down here.
Have you made it out yet?
Well, there's separate warps I can go into. And I'm probably gonna die a lot because I'm not trained anymore. Like, I haven't played it in quite a long time. There should also be a checkpoint in this room, because it's like, if you die, then you go all the way back to two rooms back, and then you have to go into that warp again.
Yeah, every level needs more checkpoints.
Frinny is too slippery. I'm not used to that anymore.
Why don't you play the prototype then, see how much you complain about...
Yeah, I know, but... One is...
There's a three-tile-wide gap I can't get into in this wall of text room. So I guess I'm just stuck here. I can't get into the three-tile-high passage because of wall hugging. Like, I was just researching how it works. Yeah, I'll let you talk.
There's six challenges I have to complete, and then every challenge has a terminal at the end, which lists three numbers, so that's something to do with the order, and I just died, so I have to try again.
Man, I'm glad I'm not playing player 2.
I'm not sure what you still have to do.
I have to wait for you. I got out of the maze. I haven't died yet. There's no challenges for me to die on. Yeah.
2 is 2, 3, 1. 4, 4, 2. 6, 1, 9. 7, 2, 1. So, now I have 6 times 3 numbers, and I don't know in which order they should go.
Oh wait, are you at the wall of numbers now?
Yeah, now I have like 10 slots I can fall into, and the reset button. And another terminal here. This is the passcode checker. Your friend has probably already made it to the wall of text, and
yeah,
you probably don't know what it is. Oh well.
It's a bunch of numbers.
Yeah, okay. The two of you will need to put your parts of the puzzle together if you want to crack the code. If you mess up, just leave the room and come back. You must leave the room. Make sure to reset the password too. Entering the wrong number will also reset the password. And there's another terminal here that's... Don't tell the other person this. But I have something I'm not supposed to tell you. But it's funny, it's not confidential. It says, don't tell the other person this, but I think you're the prettier one of the two.
Oh.
So...
A very big and long jump cut later.
You know, I thought this level was going to be more fun than this.
Yeah.
We spent almost half an hour on this. My time taken says 27:13. So... I don't know, should we ask?
Apparently, my recording stopped. I'm not sure when or what, but... I don't have a recording.
Oh, that's just... Okay, that's terrible.
Yeah, that's terrible.
Should we ask Lollipop on Discord? Or like hint at a wall of text? Because there's...
But anyway, if I don't have a recording, then it's like... Should we do it again or something, or...
Well, I don't know. You know, I thought the puzzles were going to be better than this. Like... Well, this is like Petscop tier puzzle cracking. And I can't get into this 3-tile high gap passage. Because of wall hugging. Like, even if you're not touching the wall... Okay, as far as I've found, there's an...
Well, anyway, like, there's still this room with the spikes in several directions. And there's...
I got out of the maze on my own, spikes. So... Yeah.
Yeah, but...
What? 24 spikes, okay.
Yeah, 24 spikes in all separate directions.
So good to know it won't crash on Linux.
Hmm?
It won't crash on... That was a reference to my Unshackled video where,
too many spikes?
Too many spikes. Crashed the level 3 times. Anyways, how am I gonna continue if I can't get into the 3-tile? I can't get into the 3-tile gap unless unlocking the passcode like tells me where I should go. I should do this special thing, but I can't get into this passageway. So I'm not. There's nothing I can do. It's not like hey, pick the correct path or something. I can't go anywhere. Do you want to just open up your player 2 in a bed and look at the scripts and see what the passcode is and enter it in?
Yeah, I guess.
Alright, yeah.
If trinkets zero stop. At the end of the script, there's if trinkets zero stop. That's very useful.
I know.
0, 1. The
one.
So 0 and 0, 1, 7,
7,
3,
3,
6, and 5.
6, 5. So 0, 1, 7, 3, 6, 5.
Yeah.
Alright.
So, let me reset it. Zero.
Zero.
One.
Yeah, zero. One.
And then seven, seven, right?
Seven, yep. Three.
Yeah. 6, 5.
Six. Yeah, 6, 5.
It should say correct now, but it doesn't.
I'm going to unironically think of asking Lollipop whether he's playtested his level. Like, seriously, this three tile high gap I can't get into, and what appears to be broken scripts, so.
Like the third number, if 2 is on, then it turns 3 on. But then the fourth one, if 4 is on, then it turns 5 on. Which is a little weird. It's either bugged or it's obfuscated, I guess. Or I'm missing anything. 4 is on, then 5.
Well, let's just blame the VScript. I mean, PHP is better than VScript, and Lua, and JavaScript.
It looks like this is a little bit incorrect. Like, it's not possible to actually jump from the third flag to the fourth, actually, or off by one.
Oh! Oh, so he hasn't playtested this level.
Just imagine if we had tried to complete the actual puzzle and then tried to get the code right and then it doesn't work.
I know. I was browsing Programming Hume on my phone and I found this Twitter post. It should be relevant. Our new software consultancy produces what we call raw code, guaranteed not to have passed through continuous integration or any kind of onerous testing. The result is a probably richer and more authentic software experience. So, you know, slightly irrelevant, because this wasn't tested.
Yeah. If you see this search result for flag 13, it's never actually checked. It's only turned on and off, but not checked.
Oof. We should probably file a bug report or something.
Yeah, probably.
This sounds like raw code. You know, code that has never been tested. As a consumer of raw code, you'll witness software behaving in surprising ways, ways which even we as developers couldn't have anticipated. That's exciting to me, but...
So you're sure there's not like some kind of hint in my level where I have to point you to some kind of invisible hole in the wall?
There's no invisible hole in the wall. And I'm pretty sure. I don't know what I could actually do to like advance somewhere, so I'm just gonna edit the level.
Yeah, well, I also edited my level because, you know, the code pad. Those gravity lines are now gone. There's a warp token. Oh, and Lollipop said that we should like tell each other what we see when we enter the next room. So maybe you should do that.
Okay.
So there was a warp token, and I'm now in some kind of room with, well, I can only go left. There's no terminal, there's 5 different slots I can fall into, and it seems like, well, one of them is not gonna lead me to death and the others are, I guess. Enjoying the change of scenery. Anyways, it's time for quick time shafting. There are 5 shafts to choose from.
Oh my god, I forgot to copy my save too. This is what happened with Unshackled 2, I forgot to copy my save.
You forgot to copy your save?
Yeah, cause different file name, so.
You do have your save for this level, right?
Yeah, I save for the level.
Yeah, okay. So there are 5 shafts to choose from, but only one of those shafts won't kill you. That's exactly what I said. So how do you figure out which shaft to fall down? Well, that's up to your partner. Okay, so I guess I do have to wait for you.
Yeah.
So editors know, there will be a text box on your screen, but pay it no mind. It's just there so you can't flip. Ah, so that's why he asked. Press whatever key you use to flip and everything will be fine. So, I can just guess because it's just 5 slots. You can't flip. You can't flip, yeah.
Okay. This is an empty room I'm in now, and
I keep falling. I keep having to fall down slots. It's not like.
All right, there's 5 shafts to choose from 2, for me.
Oh, and it's kind of broken because. Oh no, it isn't.
I can see your spikes to the platforms. All right, number 4. I can literally see the spikes to the platforms because of my texture pack.
That's fun.
You know, that's why my platforms are transparent, so... Because people kept hiding shit behind platforms when the levels are playing. Like, alright. Alright, you kind of suck. What the fuck? That was pretty easy, wasn't it? It gets harder. Okay, there's a list of songs I listen to while making this level. Not sure if that's important. Oh, there's another shaft.
So there's some weird number pattern when I fall down, because every room I can choose 5 shafts, and the first one is 4, and then 2, and then 4 again.
Okay, there's a shaft, why isn't there... Okay, there's no... There's all of these were checkpoints. I got past one of the shaftings. I got past the first shaft. There's another, like, series of shafts, and you need to help me with that, so I have to wait for you to get through your own. Okay, yeah, what are my numbers supposed to be?
4, 2, and then 4.
I can't get... I can only get to 2 because of my placement. So... I can only get to 2, and 1 and 2, so... Yeah, apparently they're out of order. Like, it says you have my numbers, but they're out of order. So... I can only access 1 and 2 right now. Looks like the first one I can only access 1 and 2.
Next is 3. Ooh, I'm starting to... Oh. So...
Oh, wait. Oh, I can... Never mind. There's spikes in the platforms again, but I can see through those platforms again. This level's great. I love my texture pack. So this is 3, this Maybe. Is... There's 5... This is 2, 4, 1, 3. In case you didn't get down all your numbers. Oh, I have to write it down?
How many of these are there?
There's 2 series of shafts. It says please wait for your part. Okay, there's only 2 series of shafts for me at least.
Maybe I'll write down the...
Oh, there's a series of numbers. Three, two, five, one, four, three, five, one, two. Okay, there's a bunch of numbers, and I don't think... I can actually write it down. You know, I could pause the game.
I have something to write down, actually, so...
Alright, that's 3. Hold on. I have a text file. I use Envim. Envim is the best.
Yeah, but it's nice to have something separate, like piece of paper, because otherwise it's gonna be... you gotta keep switching. And that's annoying, probably.
No, it's fine. Hold on. Okay, that's 3... 2... Pause menu is... Okay, stop. I need to get better at Envim. Okay, 2... 5, 1, 4, 3, 5, 1, and 2.
That's probably... Okay, that seems like the thing I have to follow. Okay, so I wrote down what you said.
Yeah, they're out of order. Yeah, so 3, 2, 5, 1, 4, 3, 5, 1, 2. Okay, I don't need the numbers because I can see through the platforms.
Yeah. Okay. So 3, 2.
Just press and just really quickly and press enter.
Do you need the numbers I see? Because
I don't need the numbers. I can make it through just fine because I can see through the platforms and see if the platforms have spikes or not.
Yeah, okay, but you said like, are you ready for that?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna read out some numbers as well. All right, that's two. First number is two.
Two.
Four. And I'm gonna write it down as well.
Like, where is this?
The second shaft. Three.
Yeah, 3, 2, 5, 1, 4, 3, 5, 1, 2.
There's seven.
Seven?
Nine. Six. Okay, that's all the numbers. That was all the numbers for the second shaft.
3, 2, 7, 9, 6?
Second shaft numbers are 2, 4, 3, 7, 9, 6.
2, 4, 3, 7, 9, 6.
Yeah.
5, 1, 4. Five, one, two. Yeah. Songs I listened to while making this level. And there's Terminal. That was pretty easy, wasn't it? It gets harder. And yeah, there's also way back up, but it probably ends in spikes. I don't want to die again.
Yeah, there's that's what I saw there.
Oh, okay, there's no spikes here.
There's no checkpoint here.
Yeah, there's no checkpoint.
Okay, so I'm gonna get up there again.
Let's just enter the number you had. Oh, wait. That was wrong.
Oh, what's this?
I hope you and your partner remembered the numbers in his shaft, because now is the time to put them to use. This time, the order is irrelevant. Once you enter all the numbers...
I don't have a keypad. I have a bunch of invisible tiles, and apparently... But they show up for me because of my resource pack, so...
Yeah. Once you input all the numbers, just check the other terminal. Not entering a wrong number is the same as restarting. Yeah, except you gotta leave the room again. If you get
this terminal tells me that your partner should ask your partner to describe what they see, so... I'm not... Is there any weird pattern in a room that you're in?
Yeah, well, the numbers are in a strange order.
Okay, I don't know
it's
how that
like
help.
From 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so it's 3, 7, 0, 1, 9, 5, 4, 2, 8, 6.
That's checkpoint I can't get to.
Sorry?
There's a checkpoint that I can't get to. Okay, I'm just gonna... Alright.
So let me just write down...
What the... Okay. Alright, some internal scripting was going on. I got teleported back to over here. Alright. So. There. Go to room is just used.
Only just.
Oh, okay.
Correct.
Alright, so there was go to room. I just triggered go to room just now. Okay, let's see.
So nice room, isn't it? It's like it looks like this is supposed to be disappearing platforms, but it's like walls and it's single tile walls. Well, your friend has a room just like this, but some blocks are invisible. Yeah, except you can see them probably.
Yeah, I can. The better way would be to like create entity a bunch of platforms and then destroy platforms. That'd be better.
Yeah.
That's what I use in patrol.
Reference lines. And there's now a warp token and a terminal. Okay, I think that's enough invisible blocks. Now it's time for quick time warping.
Yeah, I'm at there too.
Like its predecessor, you need to enlist the help of your partner to figure out which warp tokens to use. Oh, help. Note it's their warps, not yours. So,
Okay, I see it. There's an arrow pointing to one warp token in the first room.
Yeah.
And it's, okay, there's another arrow too. So...
yeah, I have, two arrows pointing to the second on the bottom row.
Okay, we need to make, like, a coordinate system for telling which warp token to go
yeah,
to.
Yeah, bottom second, I guess. That's what my arrows point to.
I have an arrow pointing to the second one from the... okay, let's make a coordinate system.
Yeah,
bottom
so...
bottom second. Or bottom... okay, bottom fourth. Bottom fourth. I have one pointing to bottom okay. fourth. Bottom second works
I'll
for me.
I'll write down what you say, you write down what I say.
Okay, so, alright. So, first room, I have a warp token pointing to bottom fourth.
Yeah. And the second one, top fourth.
Okay, sixth room... have you... tell me what mine is at the sixth room. I can tell you yours first.
Yeah, hold on, that's... it's getting confusing. Your fifth one was, five, right?
My fifth one was top fourth. I'm at a sixth room.
Let me just tell you what I see, because I'm starting to focus too much on my own code.
Bottom fifth. And yours is top second in the sixth room.
Okay, top second.
Oh, I'm out.
Alright. 412532. Oh, shit. Yeah, I'm out too. And there's terminal. Onwards. The next section awaits. Just kidding, it's over. I hope you enjoyed.
Yeah. I think this is just out of bounds now.
I guess it's now outer space because nothing's happening anymore.
Yeah, apparently it's over. So,
so it was an original level.
Yep.